Hey guys, Captain Walnut here, back on the AFB server, and man, have you guys missed a lot. That's not because I haven't been recording, that is because YouTube hates me. I've tried to upload the past 5 episodes, it's all rendered. You know, I'd render it, I delete my source footage, and YouTube just, I don't know, either my internet would pause in the middle of the upload, it takes about, 8 hours to upload an episode, and it just would refuse to go through, or it would upload all the way, and then it'd just be sitting at processing stage and be like, processing, 91% complete. And then it would sit there at that level for probably 2 hours, and then suddenly I'd come back to my computer later, and it would still say processing, but then I'd go to my video manager in another tab, and it'd be like, video failed to upload, you know what I mean? So, what we're going to try to do here is I'm going to try to make 2 very short episodes of just a tour of everything that we've been up to. That guy's wigging out. There's a tour of everything that we've been up to here in the server. There's been some big changes, as you can see here. I expanded that watermelon farm. One of the episodes was actually me building that, so I'm sorry that I couldn't show you that. I did leave ladders in there, so I'm going to get in there and show you that stuff. We have a new addition to the server. His name is Spencer. He's one of my buddies from my engineering program here, and this was his first thing he built. He was so tired of our janky little storage room down the bottom of the church here that he felt the need to build a giant storage room, and it looks like a chest. So, it's the community chest. We found a skeleton spawner over there and started making that look sexy. The Sams have built a little bit of a treehouse. Brett started a big volcano. We got some cats going on at the cat lady house. I built one of my villager spawners over there. So let's just get started. Let me just take you on a tour of everything we've been up to. So the first thing, I guess, that I have to show you is our little storage room is gone. Yep, and right across through that wall is the crazy cat lady's house. I'm not going to go down and show you the strip mine, but it is big. It's huge. And actually, Spencer and I tried and failed for a while trying to get a, zipper elevator to work right here. We really wanted a zipper elevator because they're just pretty cool, and I like that they go up and down vertically rather than going around in a circle. But we might end up just building a circular elevator just because it's kind of annoying to go up and down those stairs so much. So, all right, here is the crazy old cat lady's house. You can see, it's nice and pretty. This is one of Brett's projects, and we'll see if they get on the server later. Usually I record with Brett simply because he and I are on the server at the same time, and it's convenient. But today, it's nice and early in the morning, and I figured I'd just get on and give you an update of what's been going on in this server. So we go in here, and here's her pink little carpet. This is where she sits. We got the cat lady TV channel, and then a bunch of speakers. So this is her big screen TV, I guess. And then down in her creepy little dungeon are all of her cats. These are actually all Spencer's cats, because, man, I have never met someone who's as good at getting creepered as he is. I can't tell you how many holes I've had to repair in this village because he'll just be walking around and a creeper will come out of nowhere and just blow him up. And that's actually why we got this wall of cactuses going, because, Brett and I are fine, the Sams are fine, Spencer somehow, the creepers just love him, they just come and get him. So this is our big huge community chest. We put in some iron doors, because the villagers go crazy with this thing. They love this building. They always just hide in here at night, and it gets really annoying. So we made it so only we can get in. There's some redstone going on down below here. By the way, I love that with that newest update, they fixed the double door thing. There's no redstone for these pressure plates and these double doors. But there is redstone for this button. Oh, hey, chicken. Yeah, just feel free. Go right in there. So they open at the same time and open long enough to let you go in. You can hear some pistons activating down there. It's simple redstone. I don't mind showing it to you real quick. Let's see here. Let me open it up a little bit. I hope Spencer doesn't get angry at me for opening it up. Oh, axe. No. Of course, I jump in here before I make a new one. Well, time to make an iron axe. Oh yeah, and you see how I don't have any of my diamond stuff on me? That's because I've died so many times. You have no idea. We went to the Nether and built some new stuff down there. Blaze farm down there. Ah, come here. There we go. I hate the Nether. I didn't mean to make a pick! Where's my brain at? Alright, get 2 sticks while I'm here. Did not need a pick. Actually, you know, before I do this, I'm going to check the equipment chest just to see if we have an axe in here. There's an almost dead axe. Eh, I'll use that just for now. I can't believe I made a new pick. That was silly. Put down here. Why? Someone's been leaving this thing unorganized. My OCD is getting to me now. I'll get to it later. Won't bore you guys with me fixing that. Right, back to showing you this. Yeah, so I hate the nether now. Oh, man. I've died so many times in that place. Usually it's fine for me, but, you know, just the right amount of lag comes at just the right time, and, ugh. Alright, so, what are you doing down here, chicken? No. This is my place. You can't be here. There needs to be a torch there. There we go. I know we have plenty of torches down here. It's just that we're joking around about spiders and just started placing torches like crazy. Anyway, so there's a button right above this block on the outside there that comes down and feeds this this redstone line. And it was a challenge to get this both to happen because, you know, you can only feed this block directly above the door, this block two blocks beside the door, or the block directly under the door in order to get to open. And if you have a torch right here where the sand block is, it will power the cobble above it, and that would power the redstone, and the redstone's being triggered by the button. It would circle around. I know we could have easily moved the button over here, but that's just not, that's not as convenient because it's a whole block over from the door. Oh, man. So basically what we have happening is the redstone circles around, goes down here, and then hits this delay, basically. It feeds into here immediately, and then hits this delay. When the delay's finished triggering, it just simply hits these pistons, which cut off the circuit and allows the doors to close. That's all there is to it. It's very simple. All right, so tour the community chest. We got materials here on the first floor. You know, we got our ores, we got our redstone. That's my favorite chest. Just got random stuff here, random stuff there. Guess that's a nether chest now. Wow. I guess our nether prod. These double chests used to be full of cobble. So, someone's been at it a lot. Oh no, I'm lagging. Alright, hold on just 1 second, guys. Oh, there we go. yeah. Get back here. There we go. Yep, we got plenty of sand. There's our wood chest. Dirt. Man, someone's been using that a lot, too. Gravel. Our bank of... Well, we need to go to a coal run again soon. But yeah. So, first floor materials. Second floor gear. Third floor is a lounge, and the fourth floor is the hotel room. So we just got our basic gear here. You know, the most important mob drops are arrows and gunpowder, so we got specialized chests for that, and then the random ones. You already saw this chest. And, of course, tons of food. And then we got our nice little lounge, a nice little fountain, and a little painting behind it. Some cute little planters. Let's contemplate the art. Yes, art. Anyway, like I said, I might be splitting this up into two episodes, so we'll see. I'm going to record it all at once, and then I'll just probably stop it somewhere and start a new episode. But this is a hotel room. Yep. And so that is the community chest. And, yeah. Alright, next building. You already saw the cat building? Let's go on up inside here. Yeah. This is Brett's little Skittle box. Got that from Vintage Beef. You know, a box of Skittles. Yeah. Oh, close the door behind me. Oh, that's right. We used to have pressure plates and all of here, but villagers would come in into these buildings at night, stand on the pressure plates, and then zombies would get in here and get trapped inside here, and then when they tried to leave, they would break the door down. Yeah. So, I have shown you guys this melon farm before in one of my other videos. But just to give you a quick premise of how it works, the melon would grow there on that empty dirt block, or any of these empty dirt blocks here, the untilled ones. Both of these pistons are bud switches. This is the main bud switch, though. It triggers this, which pushes a piston backwards, pushes the block back into here, which will allow the redstone to conduct through. Oh, look, I got my repairman back there on that floor working hard. Pushes the redstone, allows the redstone to conduct through the block into the repeater. Repeater goes up into a torch, which powers this one diagonally. This one's also powered diagonally by the block being back behind it. So that triggers both of these when the thing grows. And then the glass panes are to keep the melons from shooting across the aisle, it just forces them to fall straight down. So that's a pretty simple melon farm design, pretty compact. It keeps us pretty well serviced. Oh, actually, guys, I gotta stop recording for just 1 second. Someone's calling me, so be back in just a bit. Okay, and we're back. Sorry about that, guys. So where was I? Oh, you might notice that some of the doors are missing here. We used to have hundreds of villagers wandering around here because I figured out that glitch that Doc M had in his last, not his last one, but one of his recent videos where all those villagers were spawning infinitely. The trick basically is you have to move the center of your village. That's all there really is to it. So I got one of my villager spawners set up here. Just sort of a few changes to it. Basically, I had my villagers glitching into the walls and dying. This is a half slab underneath the block, you know, the upside down half slab with a regular half slab on top of it. That's why it looks like a full block, just shifted down by one. But I had a problem with my villagers glitching through the wall and then dying, taking suffocation damage. I don't know how that happens. So I just did the whole water with pressure plates trick to keep them pushed into the middle. But basically this made it so I moved the center of my village and it glitches the game a little bit. So the villagers start spawning infinitely. And you can see here that I haven't, none of us have built any of these golems. They spawned, I think three of them spawned naturally from this village. One of them spawned naturally from that village and has since made his way over here. There's four of them, if you can't add. Alright, actually, I'm not going to get over into... I just thought of something that you can see the treehouse in the distance there. I'm not going to go and show off the treehouse or Brett's volcano. Mostly because I know that Brett... I know that the Sams record, and I don't want to take away from their view count. And I know that Brett's actually going to start recording here soon, too, which I know you guys can't wait for because you've told me so many times that you wish you had a Brett eye view of some things going on. So he's going to start recording here in a little bit as soon as he gets, you know, $20 or something scraped together to buy Fraps. And yeah, he recently got a new computer that can actually handle recording, which is awesome. And so, yeah, this here is our skeleton spawner. Spencer and I were caving one day, and we found a skeleton spawner deep down in the earth here, or deep down in the Minecraft earth. And so they go up through the wall here, go through a little faucet, and then fall down a thing of glass panes. And then we have a lighting system, basically. There's a T flip-flop down below. When you turn off the lights, the light here turns off. And when the lights in the spawner are on, these lights turn on. Same thing with down below. We have another exact same button. These two buttons are linked together all the way down below there. So you can turn them off either from up here or down there without having to run up and down these stairs. It's nice because you can sort of, as you're coming in here to get some XP, you can turn off the lights and run down in. And in the meantime, about here, they're going to start, when you get to this level, they're going to start spawning because you're within range of the spawner. And get going. So you can see here, same thing. This light's off, and it's directly below that light up there. I'll get in there and show you the redstone here in a bit. The spawner's actually, I think, 7 blocks below this this piece of sandstone here. I'm going to start building some other stuff in here to do while you're waiting for skeletons to spawn. Then you got a switch which you can raise or lower the killing floor. If it's raised like this, then the skeletons are 2 hits. And it's an XP farm. If it's lowered, they will die on impact. So I guess while we're waiting for them to get going, we'll go on down here and I'll show you the redstone. Right. So the spawner is right here. I'm not using a door because doors leak light. So I'm using dirt instead so you can get in there. Let's start right schmear. With the buttons that turn on and off stuff. So here is... Oh, crap. Sorry. So here is the buttons on the redstone lamp. It comes directly out and goes around to the T flip-flop. This is the redstone, you know, little tower that comes down from the above button. But it has the exact same redstone layout as down here. So they both join together right there. I don't need an OR gate because I just have these two repeaters. And then it just goes directly into an inverter, which powers a normal T flip-flop. Now, the reason we have an inverter is so that it triggers as soon as you press the button rather than after the button releases. If you just had the redstone going directly to the T flip-flop, the T flip-flop wouldn't trigger until after the button releases, so it'd light up for the button pressing, and then it would go dark for a split second as the delay for getting all the way up to the other button happens, and then it would turn on, meaning the lights were on, or vice versa. So that's simply how that works. And then we got the return line. Here's the output going down to the lights until the lights turn on, and then going into the block beside the redstone lamp to tell the redstone lamp to turn on. And this is the return line to go up to the above light to tell it to do the same thing. I don't need to go up there because it's exactly the same as this. It's just a spiral of redstone going up there. And then this is fairly straightforward. There's redstone lamps right here. You know, this is on the block above the redstone lamp. And it's just the same way all the way around. There's a redstone lamp right in the diagonal block down below here. The elevator's right behind this wall, so that's why we're not going in there. Okay. And then I will show you this little bit of redstone in a bit. That has to do with the pistons turning on and off. Yeah. So let me go up to that. Actually, can I even get into that right now? You know, I don't think I can. So I'm going to turn off the spawner, actually, and then dig up this floor a little bit so I can show you it. So we'll turn on the lights, and I guess I have to punch all these guys, don't I? I don't have a potion of healing on me right now. So give me a second. I'm going to punch all these guys. I know you, that's pretty boring to watch, and I'll be back. All right, so Sam just logged on, and I've been chatting him up for a while, but I'm back to it. All right, yeah. So I wanted to show you this thing working. There you go. And the way we have it set up is got the redstone coming out from behind it, then the repeater going to this block right here, pulling the power from that block. And then I'm just going to open all this stuff up here. Oh, am I going to be able to get out of here easily? Well, now I will be. Yeah, actually that's all I need to do to get in. So yeah, it was powering this block. Then it comes down here into here. This repeater is necessary. I'll show you that in just a second. But, so it comes in here and simply goes around and powers all of these blocks. So it powers all the perimeter blocks. They are at three. Wow, I just glitched the redstone there. They're at three ticks because I want them to be all synced, including the center one. This is necessary to get the center one to work. So basically what it does is it powers this block right here. So remember, this block is getting powered by this repeater. So let me go up or go around to the other part. Okay. So that's the block that's getting powered by the repeater. So that powers the redstone below it. Just simply goes in here. Powers this redstone torch, powers this block right here. There's a repeater sitting on this block facing in, which powers another block with a torch sitting on it, which powers that center piston above it. Sorry, I can't pull it apart to show you guys, but that's how that works. And that's a three tick delay going into that, so that's why I have three ticks on all of this stuff here, so that all triggers at the same time. So that's all there really is to that. And I'm going to stop recording again while I close this thing up, and I'll see you in a second. I'm so sad that I died so many times. I had so much nice enchanted stuff on me. This is all I have left. I mean, not that these are bad by any means, but I had, you know, I had diamond armor that was all nicely enchanted. I had a really awesome bow. It was not an infinity bow. But it was a, you know, power 5, I think punch 2. I'm just so sad that it's that it's all gone. And I, as obviously, I haven't gotten back around to enchanting my stuff back up again, just because I don't have the heart to spend all that time sitting there doing stuff while. Oh, was it raining? Oh, poop. I think I might need safety rails. Okay, coming back. What? Oh, okay. That was weird. Chunk errors. Fun. Let me run back and get my stuff. Oh, geez, server. Hello. Thank you. That was weird. I must be lagging pretty hard here. Yeah. I'm going to stop recording. Okay. Got everything back, but lost those 22 levels. Darn it. I'm just using, this is just the enchanted bow from the skellies, not from me doing anything. Oh, boy. That was annoying. Yeah, so let me pay a little bit closer attention to running up here now. this is my little pet project. I think this is going to be the center of my base, eventually, not like my big main base. I still want to build. I'm trying to find a giant canyon in one of the extreme hills biomes that I can turn into, put a big huge dam across it and then flood it all and then build some cool stuff. Also want it to be in a jungle biome. Darn zombies breaking down my doors. Yeah. Alright, so time to go to the nether. And I know. I keep dying here, but whatever. Oh yeah. I'm gonna break these signs. He just told me that he saw them. So yeah, basically Sam glitched through the roof one day on top of the bedrock, so I had to break a hole through the bedrock, so that's what that is up there. That's all that goes to. So here we are in the nether. We moved, and I have to change, because my computer is not the best computer in the world. I gotta get rid of smooth lighting in order to be at any reasonable frame rate while here in the nether. And actually, hold on, I gotta change particle settings to minimal, and my render distance to medium. Or actually, I think normal, or it's called normal, right? It can usually keep it at far. Well, I'm getting 30 right now. Cool. We're good. I'm good to go. Fraps. I have fraps forced to 30. So this is our cool little thing. Oh, yeah. I'll show you that one first before I show you the nether fortress. Speaking of the nether fortress, though, we spent... Oh, man. Spencer, Brett, and I all got into the nether and went off in three different directions looking for nether fortresses. And couldn't find anything. Brett finally found one at Z-1200 and X-800 or something like that. And I am moving right now. It's just buggy? Am I not moving right now? What? Oh, I guess I am moving. There we go. Yep, I'm here. It's a long ride. What the heck? I must be lagging so badly. This is weird. Anyway, and while I'm here, I meant to fill these holes back in, so I'll do that. That was me digging around trying to find something. Trying to find the way to the nether fortress, and of course I dug 300 blocks in the wrong direction, because I'm a smart one. Yeah. So Brett and Spencer and I all went off in three different directions trying to find another fortress, and Brett finally found one. And then on his way back, he found, three more, much closer. So we built one at the closest one. but yes, we have here, nether portals can't currently track above the old height limit. So right there is, at the top of the portal, is Y128. We're just above a big old ocean biome here. There's a jungle biome out in the distance there. And we wanted to be above an ocean because we wanted to be able to, be able to fall without killing ourselves. The whole point of this is because Brett and I were so tired of only having, the limited amount of arrows that we could make from chickens and from flint and stuff. So we just wanted to build a quick little sky mob trap. And this thing works fairly well. And then we have just two little tree farms here, so you have something to do while you're waiting. And you all saw this in our last season with the cobblestone generator. This is just your typical cobblestone generator. And then who's burning something? Got some wood going here. Huh. Anyway. And then you just basically come in these doors here. And you can throw out all the zombie flesh through the trash can there. You can't walk out because it's an upside down half slab. We keep the doors there because when skeletons land, they can shoot you. And we got some reasonably good amount of mob drops. I recently carted back nearly this entire double chest full of arrows so that we could use it. But yeah, that's all there is to this thing. And let me walk my way back over to the nether again. And I'll meet you there, actually. I'll meet you back at the original nether portal. Okay, so here we are back in the main one. And these guys know how OCD I am. I'm not actually OCD. I just pretend I am. I guess I'm more of a perfectionist than OCD. Although, aren't they kind of the same thing? I don't know. Anyway, we have upside down half slabs here so that you can still ride through there without having to worry about pigmen spawning on the track. And let's go. So now we're going over on the really long railway to the nether fortress. It's located at nether coordinates are, I think, X400, Z300, or Z300, depending on what country you're from. I know it really annoys the Sams they're from England. It really annoys the Sams when I'm like Z. They're like, no, it's Z! I'm like, okay, calm down. They don't really get that annoyed, but whatever. Yeah. So I guess I'll meet you guys there. Like I said, it's quite a long ride. I'll be on this for about another 3 minutes. So see you in a bit. All right. So here we are. Did not mean to do that. There we go. We got quite a nice long staircase going up to the roof. We're down here for the minecart to go up into the roof of the nether so that we can be there. We got a little fortress here with doors and stuff. You know, I don't know why today. Today is the day, it seems. Maybe it's because I'm recording. I don't know. I need to clean my computer out. We got a little bit of a nether wart farm here. It needs to be harvested. I'll get on that in a little bit. And then a bunch of doors going out to the rest of the nether. And a little blaze XP farm. This has been Sam's. This has been... I like it. This is new. I haven't seen this yet. this has been Spencer's project because he loves XP farms. He's been just farming XP like a madman ever since he got on the server. And so he and I got in here and did some of this redstone. Open, then close. Why? I wonder why they haven't spawned yet, actually. I'm within spawning range. That's a very good question. You know, I'm going to go find out. Hello? Blazes. I gotta watch this for a little bit. See what happens here. Anyway, so he decided to... There we go. He decided that we're gonna use half slabs to push them down in. Because if they get stuck in that block, they won't die or they won't take damage. And they also can't jump back up to the next level. If it was a full block... And I'm going to turn off the sound, or at least turn it way down, because these guys are annoyingly loud. If it was a full block and they landed on top of the full block, they'd be able to jump back up to the next level. So here, this way, we get it slightly more efficient, and here we're just pushing them all down to one corner, rather than worrying about, you know, pushing them to the center, because that's just annoyingly annoying, trying to lay it all out. Ugh, I died so many times trying to get this thing blocked off. Is there a way for me to get back in there and show you this thing without breaking the glass? I don't know if there is. I want to show you the redstone for this. You all know how to blaze farms work. I don't need to show you that part. I'm going to break the glass. Oh, really? Okay, well, I guess I'll have to go get some glass to fill it back up again. It is very cramped back here, I know. So basically what happens is... This right here, the switch is behind that, comes on up here. Alright, let me figure this out. I'll be back in a second. I really apologize for the lagginess and all these little mistakes this episode, everyone, but I think it's because we're running this, as you know, or may or may not know, we don't have a host for a server or anything. We're pretty poor. We can't afford to, you know, rent out server space. So we're just running this from Brett's desktop. And he and I log on from laptops. some nice Asus laptops, so I was about to have a nice little advertisement for Asus. But the moral of the story is that his desktop has been on for, I think, probably 2 weeks straight now, and it probably needs restarted. So that's probably why we're having so many bugs here. But anyway, so the switch is behind this block, goes up on top of here to power all of the top pistons to open and close the gate. And that's just very simple to understand. It just goes up and powers some redstone torches. Then we have the delay for the button to time out how long they need to be crushed. And if you watch my B00 video, it's a response to one of B00's video where he wanted a more compact timing delay circuit. That's all this is. It's basically just an RS-NOR latch with a long delay and some clever block usage to try. Like, this is powering a block below it because we needed to lower down the delay from where the kind of RS-NOR latch it was. But basically what happens is it triggers here, turns off this torch, which runs out that way, which turns off this bit of redstone, which turns on this torch, which keeps this trail powered while the delay is getting back around. And when the delay reaches back around to here, the pulse reaches here, it turns this torch off, and then that wraps around and turns this torch on. There we go. And then as the delay finishes going out through here, it keeps this thing on as well. So it basically is doubling the delay for the number of repeaters here. So we only need half the number of repeaters we normally would. That's the whole point of it, just so we can save space. So that's all the redstone back here. And let's see if I can get out of here. There we go. It's a little convoluted back here. Sorry about it not being very clean. But like I said, we are just worried about not dying rather than making it clean, so we didn't build a huge area for ourselves. So let me kill these guys. Open it, let them fall in, close it. Did I close it? Yes, I closed it. Crush it. They're actually in here, but graphical glitch puts them above. And actually, I need to go get a potion of harming from up here. Oh, don't you dare, you ghast. Potion of fire resistance. Do we not have any potions of harming on us? Really? No. Okay, whatever. I really don't feel like crafting one. But you know how. You've seen these things work before. They're all basically one punch after this. See, there you go. There we go. I just couldn't punch him for some reason. But that's basically how it works. Alright, I can't think of anything else in this episode that I wanted to show you. That's basically all we've been up to on this server. Like I said, you guys have missed out on a couple of episodes here. I apologize for that. But YouTube has just been... just doesn't like me for some reason. And so I can't really help that. And yeah, I'm going to try and keep uploading regularly, but as I have said before in some of my tutorial videos, this is finals week coming up right after this weekend, and I cannot, I can't really do anything during that. I gotta be focusing on school, not focusing on entertaining you guys. I still will be playing though in my free time, so yeah. Alright, well, thank you for watching. And I'm going to get back to working on some projects and studying for my finals. And I'll see you all later. Talk to you later. Bye-bye.